Hello and welcome back to another Jack and the Mac album review. Today we're going to be doing Lark's Tongues and Aspic, another album by King Crimson. I've done two in a row now, so that's pretty cool, I guess. This album, part two, Lark's Tongues and Aspic part two, is probably my favorite track from this album. That track does remind me of some tracks from Red a little bit. Yeah, so overall, the album I'd probably give... Actually, I'm not going to get there yet. I do have some things to go over. I don't remember a lot from this album, honestly. I haven't listened to it in a while. And it may be like, John, why isn't that the case? You're meant to re-listen to everything. Let's just say I pretty much finished all the King Crimson albums a while back. I already listened to, I think, Red and In the Court of Crimson King, although I reviewed In the Court of Crimson. I listened to Red previously because, and then, you know, because it's a great album. Check out my review there if you haven't already. Overall, I would say Lark's Tongues and Aspic sounds similar enough to Red. It isn't really, like, all the way like it, though. Either way, I'd give the album a 9 out of 10. Yeah, I'm sorry about the review. Not really being short, but more or less my lack of... Yeah, as you can probably tell. But I haven't really been listening to a lot of music recently. I've kind of been stockpiling on a lot of my old stuff. I will get back into the groove with more reviews, I guess, soon. I'm still making videos, but you know what I mean. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the album review. Goodbye.